What's up guys, Blackwar and welcome back to another video, and today we're back on Pro Cycling Manager 2020 for stage number 13 of our Tour de France playthrough with Groupama FDJ, a stage that will take us from Chatel-Guyon to the Puy-Marie, 185 km, for a very tough finish at the Puy-Marie on Romain Bardet's home roads for the final Tour de France of the AG2R leader, or at least the final Tour de France as the AG2R leader. We are going to enter the region of Auvergne, such a French word, and I don't think it translates. I don't think you translate all of our regions. But yeah, we're going to enter these roads wearing the yellow jersey of leader of the Tour de France with Thibaut Pinot. For those who've missed the previous episodes, I highly recommend you to go and check them out. The final two episodes have been honestly rather successful for the team. I do like the fact that we're first in yellow, second in green, and third in the mountain. If we could translate that 1-2-3 into a 1-1-1, that would be stupendous for Thibaut. But yeah, today's stage, as I said, it's a big one. A lot of points to take for the Polka jersey. I'm hoping that David has a good day. If he does, we'll definitely send him in a breakaway to try and come back at Mathieu Ladanius will try to go in the breakaway to get some points for the green jersey. But yeah, mainly the aim is to keep the jersey, the yellow jersey, in the team today. Alright, it's an average day, we'll say, for the team. Plus 2 for Thibaut, though, that is important. Plus 1 for Mathieu, that is also important. Minus one for David. We're gonna try and send him in a breakaway. I mean, if I don't try today, I might never try. So I don't want to take too much. Well, I don't want to be too far down compared to Lutsenko. Lutsenko already attacking. Therefore, yeah, we are gonna go in the breakaway with Mr. David Gaudu as soon as I can find a gap. There we go. Gonna follow Jan Polank. I shouldn't be, like, the peloton should not chase me down, let's be real, I'm 40 minutes down. And they are not, at least I hope they're not. Crash in the peloton. Crash, Sebastian Reichenbach has crashed with Luc Rowe and Jan Hert. All three riders will go back on their bike. That is definitely a bad thing, though. I didn't want to lose Reichenbach, and poor Reichenbach has attacked, and he has not even managed to leave the group. Nice. Nice, definitely nice. In the meantime, we're starting the Col de Cessa. 10 kilometers. It's a fast cat. So, if I want to get the points, it's now or never. Ilnur Zakarin is already out. Wow. Wow. He's out early. He's out really, really, really early. Jeez. Okay. Didn't see that coming. We're going to be able to rest for a bit with David here. Just recover some energy halfway through the climb. And then we'll go once again at a high rhythm to try and get the 10 points given at the summit of this climb. And Tom Schuntz is gone. Tom Schuntz is gone already. Okay. That's really early. That's like 2K to go. Tiege Benoot has followed him. Here's Mikel Nieve. We've got Izaguirre, Lutsenko. I did say Zagiré twice because the two of them are there. We're going to catch Tom Schuntz, the Latvian rider. And we're going to launch our attack. It might be a bit late for David. I don't know. Can we navigate through the pack here? We cannot. It's Izaguirre ahead of Nieve and me, I think. Let me take a quick look at the results. Izaguirre, Nieve, me, Lutsenko, and the other Izaguirre. It's an elder for Tiege Benoot. No points for the Belgian. Okay. We've gained 2 points on Alexei Lutsenko. Col de Guiry coming up. And Tom Schuntz leading the pack as as he did in the first climb. We're this time much higher placed to prepare any early attacks from the Latvian or from anyone, actually. Recovering energy at the front of the group. But I'm expecting them to accelerate, and by them I do mean the Astana team, because they've got three riders in the leading group, and those three riders aren't bad riders, both Izaguirre brothers and Alexei Lutsenko. They could have added Omar Fraile, and they would have been basically unbeatable. But it's an acceleration here. I need to make sure that I can go. That I can go. Sorry, back at the front. Tumshens is also coming back rather quickly, and everyone's attacking. Is that an attack from Pierre? I don't know. Who's leading? Mikel Nieve? We'll take the wheel of Mikel Nieve. We'll take the wheel of the Spaniard, the stage winner on the Giro, best climber, I believe, as well, on the Giro when he used to ride for Sky the year with Bradley Wiggins. I think completely gave up. And he's going for the 5 points at the summit of this climb. He's going to get overtaken by David Godu. Everyone has been dropped behind, and that is plus five for David today. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Lutsenko gets no points. We are now 4 points behind good old Alexei Lutsenko. Crash on the peloton. Nicolas Roche, Romain Sicard, Kevin Reza, Nicolas Arndt, and Quentin Paché have crashed. None of them are withdrawing, however. William Bonnet is currently last of the stage. He's navigating 10 minutes behind David Godu. Hopefully he can finish in the delays as I think Ilnur Zakarin. Nope, definitely not Zakarin. Jan Polank. Jan Polank made his comeback in the Greek, in the breakaway. 2 kilometers until the summit of the Côte de la Stèle. We are on a flatter terrain, if we're going to be honest. And Tish Benoot is the first one to make the move. We are in this wheel. Lutsenko is in my wheel, so I don't think we'll be able to get a 5 point gap with the Kazakh quite yet. But we're going to try and counterattack at least Tish Benoot. And oh, Lutsenko got third, didn't he? Oh, he got second. Wait. Huh? How did I get 5 points? Wait. Wait, what? They say I get 5 points. It was 44-40. It's now 49-42. So technically that means I got two and Lutsenko got five. I think this graphic is fucked here. I think I'm 7 points behind Lutsenko here. IS coming up. I'm not going to go for it in the break. Neither will I in the peloton, unless, I mean, I could just paste 7G and get, what, 3 points? I think that's what I'm going to get here. No, nope, because Lucro is, actually, Trentin's going for it. Matteo Trentin's going for it. Clément Russo got 2 points as well. Congratulations to Clément. 202, I did not get any points. I'm well and truly 55 points behind Caleb Ewan, as we are 67 kilometers away from the line. Three more KOMs and then the climb of the Puy-Marie. 2 points given away at the Côte de l'Estiade. David taking the lead in this group, making sure that Tige Benoot doesn't do anything dumb like attacking, for example. But we'll be the one making the first move. 900 meters to go. Tige Benoot in my wheel. Alex and Lutsenko as well. They're going to try and counterattack me. I should have enough energy to hold on until the line, and I will. Plus two for David. 5 points behind Alexei Lutsenko, so I believe that the graphics were indeed completely fucked in the previous climb. In the meantime, peloton slowly but surely trying to come back on the breakaway. Valentin Madouas and Thibaut Pinot, well and truly in this group. So is Mathieu Ladanius, big up. And so is Stefan Kung, although they are looking quite far down the group, we'll say. Okay, Godu's has been dropped. I mean, there's not many points left to take. I don't expect them to still be leading at the Col de Neyron. Now, if David can stay at the front and try to come back, that'd be great. But I won't chase the breakaway down. Lutsenko is going to get 2 points at the Côte d'Anglard de Salers. So he reclaims a plus 7 lead. David, I'm gonna need you to now wait for the other riders, I guess. Just go back in the peloton and try to help Thibaut as much as you can in the final climb. 15k until the line, 4k until the summit. We have two breakaways with a minute lead. And Lutsenko just dropped Tige Benoot. Okay. Well, I mean, I'm gonna have to let Lutsenko take the 5 points. So he'll be 12 points ahead of David. So despite how they're in the breakaway, Lutsenko will have more points than me at the end of the day. Well, more, a bigger gap than he had at the start. However, Thibaut is not... Oh! Oh, hello, Gap. Hello, Gap. Is Bernal going to try and bridge it? Well, we're going to see. We're going to see. Valentin can try to maybe attack for a bit. We do have... I mean, it's I mean, they're all going to come back now. Yeah, they're all going to come back. But we had a gap for a bit. That was good. That was nice. Can we come back on Lutsenko and prevent him from getting the 5 points, though? That'd be even better. Julien Lafib going for it. So am I. Yeah, we're going for the points. And we will take them. We've prevented Lutsenko from taking everything, which is good. Right, time to slow down. Time to recover energy. We haven't dropped any GC, guys, so there's no point pacing right now. We're going to slow down, allow everyone to come back, and we'll go for a hill sprint in the Pimari. 5 kilometers at an average gradient of 8, knowing that the first 3 kilometers are somewhat of a false flat, more than natural climb. And we're gone. And we're gone. We have started the Pimari. Valentin Madouas pacing. Actually, it's better if I do that. There we go. Valentin Madouas pacing attack. Bauke Mollema and Julien Alaphilippe are attacking. Valentin is not going to change his rhythm whatsoever because we are far from having entered the tough part of the climb. Richard Carapaz trying to do some stuff for Ineos Grenadiers and Egan Bernal. But he's been trashed the entire tour. He's been trashed the entire tour. The Ecuadorian winner of the Giro, definitely not in the best of shapes. Valentin is done for the day. Only Primoz Roglic has a teammate. Landa still has Peyu Bilbao, to be fair. Fair play to him. Pogacar still has Formolo, so a lot of riders still have a teammate. Alexei Lutsenko still here, if he wants to be a dickhead. Flamme Rouge, final kilometer. Julien Alaphilippe leading the way 20 seconds ahead of the peloton. Peloton led by Tom Dumoulin. Bauke Mollema trying to catch Julien Alaphilippe. Not sure he's going to have the legs. Dumoulin, though, is strong. Dumoulin is strong. Alaphilippe crumbling. 500 meters. We're going to overtake Tom Dumoulin. Primoz Roglic going for the sprint. Can the Slovenian rider win at the Pimari? Yes. Yes, he can. It's Slovenian win today ahead of Thibaut Pinot. Julien Alaphilippe will come in third place. Rigobert Urán, Bauke Mollema, Egan Bernal, Tom Dumoulin, Simon Yates, Buchmann Landa. But the big loser today, I was going to say Pogacar because I thought he was third of the GC, but he's not. But Valverde and Pogacar are going to lose a minute. Guillaume Martin will also lose some time. Nairo Quintana is going to lose big today. Nairo Quintana has lost the Tour de France on the Pimari. And there's gaps. There's 3 seconds for Roglic. Roglic is going to gain then a full 7 seconds on me today. I didn't expect that. I think he's going to overtake Egan Bernal, therefore, in the GC. But Roglic gets 3 seconds on me, then 10 seconds on the rest of the group. Adam Yates, 22. And indeed, Primoz Roglic jumps Egan Bernal in the GC, but the big loser, as I said, Nairo Quintana, he was fourth this morning. 2:46 down, he's now ninth, 5:47. What an L for the leader of Arkea Samsic. Both Martin and Martin have lost the top 10 as well, yeah? Lutsenko, 5 points on Thibaut Pinot. Thibaut is in second. David Gaudu is in third. Okay, so nice comeback from David. Right, we're now 7 points behind Lutsenko. We're still in it. We're still in the fight. We haven't given up yet. That's good. That's very, very, very good. Green jersey. Again, we're making a slight comeback. We're now less than 40 points behind Caleb Ewan. We're not in third place. Ladanius still in fourth. Big up. Bernal has assured the dominance, I don't know, on the white jersey. And Jumbo-Visma are now more than 2 seconds ahead of their followers. It's now UAE second place. 6:53 down. Astana has had a shocker today. Right. Interesting gaps. I completely forgot that there could have been gaps on this stage. But yeah, 3 seconds for Roglic. I mean, it's not too bad for me, let's be honest. Could have been much worse. Could have been much, much worse for Thibaut. And I mean, I could have finished with these lot. But yeah, losing time on Roglic is a bit peak. 1:44 is still our gap. We need to increase the gap, though, before the time trial at the Planche Belfi. Otherwise, we could potentially be in danger of getting overtaken on stage 20. But yeah, Landa is fifth at GGC, so despite losing a minute yesterday, he is now well and truly back in the top five. Valverde, Pogacar, Mollema, Quintana, Buchmann to complete the top 10. Guillaume Martin dropped to P13. Dan Martin dropped to P15. Sorry, he's lost 5 minutes today. Some big, big gaps in this stage. And I didn't really expect it. I expected like the gaps to be up to 30 seconds, maybe a minute, but not more than that. Tomorrow, we'll not see any gaps. But tomorrow, we'll see potentially a breakaway win. We're going to try our best to have one or two riders in the break so that we can go for the dub. But yeah, that'll be for tomorrow's episode. If you've enjoyed this one, though, please do leave a like down below. It would really, really mean a lot to me. If you're new on here, then consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so. I upload daily and twice during this Tirreno and Tour de France period. And yeah, follow my social media, the links are in the description down below. But I shall catch you in the very near future. My name has been Blackwar. It has been an absolute pleasure talking to you guys. Have a great day. Enjoy your Tour de France. And goodbye. Pull up in the gold I'm leading. All them other man need feeding. I don't want to go bombi. Them, I don't know what I do when I go from meeting. Leading the pack in black and I'm on with the bat. Snapping with a phone and dab. Boss up a man with a duster. Put him in the drip and sip blockbuster.